What's up, everybody? I hope you're having a wonderful day and a wonderful week. Now, I'm very excited about today. I have not done this in a while now, but I'm going to do a grow tent tour with you. I'm not going to be able to cover everything because there is a lot, but I do want to cover some of the highlighted stuff that's doing really well, so they give you kind of an idea how things have been growing. I'm also going to touch on the seedlings and show you how they're doing and just kind of give an update on that as well. So a lot coming your way. Hope you enjoy it. See you in a minute. First thing I want to highlight is this amazing Maxima wavy leaf. It's doing absolutely amazing. I love this plant, obviously because of the leaves with the waviness on the edges and the purple coloration, but the pictures themselves, see if I can get this one out of here, are absolutely stunning. They have a really high neck, which is really neat, with a very flared peristome, but more towards the top, which is really neat. They have almost like an ime look to them, except they're pure, this lime green, and they have just the smallest amount of speckling of red. I've had this plant for quite a while, and to be honest with you, I have not done a very good job of taking care of it, but it is doing very well now, and I've been giving it a lot more love. So, moving on, I'm going to come over here. This is Mira by Truncata Giant, and as you can see, it's doing very well. I've been growing it down at this increased angle. It does dry it out very fast, which I don't like, but I've been trying to do this, and it finally did it. I've been trying to entice some basiling, and as you can see here, we've got some of that going on. Very, very excited about that. Got some basils going on it, but they produce these absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous pictures. I got this from Carnivorous a little while ago, but very, very beautiful pictures. Love it very much. All right, let's see what else we can get into. If you've been following the channel, you've been watching this one grow. This is Stenophylla. And if you, well, notice, it wasn't too long ago. This plant was very small, but it has absolutely hit its stride and is starting to make these big, big leaf jumps. And so I absolutely love this plant. If you've heard me talk about before, these are known in nature to produce a ton of different growth points, up to 100 on some of the larger adult plants in nature. And so I'm very excited to watch that one grow out. But it's definitely making some huge leaf jumps here. Next here is Sumatrana by Platycyla by Vicii. And these two next to each other are siblings. But I want to show you how different the picture morphology is. So here's the first one. Very tall, very skinny. Got nice striping going on, but absolutely gorgeous, right? And let me get the other one. Sorry, doing this with one hand isn't the easiest. Here is the other one. This one produces these very flat, it's getting kind of smushed, but very flat Sumatrana-like body. There's another one. So that's why I like getting siblings, because they have such a cool dynamic as far as what the different siblings look like and the morphology of the pictures. If you remember, I have been growing these for a while. I got this from Predatory Plants. I've got several clumps of this spatulata by Rob Cantlei. And if you've ever seen Rob Cantlei's Instagram channel, these things get absolutely enormous. I guess it would help if I had it in camera, but here is one of them that is growing. Look how large they've gotten. I mean, for me, I feel like they're a slower grower, but I think that's because I was talking to Plant Prodigy, and I think it's because I've kept them so clustered together. If I separate them, they probably do a lot better, but they are growing very well, and I've got bunches of them here and there. Here's the other one that's growing out. Gosh, my camera work today is absolutely horrible, so I will try to work on that for the rest of this video. Let's see, this is, let's see, what is this? This is Peltata by SP1, absolutely beautiful. Not a lot to talk about here. It's a pretty slow grower. It just does its thing. Basil's a lot. But we'll not spend a whole lot of time on that. Here is Spectabulous by Spatulata by Cobra Vicii. And as you can see, it's got that cool Cobra Vicii peristome. So I'm very excited to see how that grows out and just see what that ends up looking like. Pretty neat. I just wanted to take a quick moment away from the tour just to say, if you're liking this content, if you're loving this channel, please subscribe to it and spread the word as we continue to grow here and on Facebook. On Facebook, we've got about 10,000 members. Here, we've got about 3,300, and we're continuing to grow. Thank you all for your support. I appreciate you so very much. Now, let's get back to the tour. This is when things start to get difficult. We got to try to get in here to get some of these. This is Platycyla by Spectabilis. And if I could just... These things are not wanting to work with me. But look how gorgeous this plant is. Gets this absolutely lime green, very soft pitchers that you can see. Lime green, if I can get it to focus, with a red peristome striping. Very, very cool. My Briggsiana is flowering, and it is flowering female. You can tell that by the elongated, if I can get it to focus, the elongated buds there. That is a female flowering, so that's very exciting. First female flower that I have. I've got a few males, but first one that's flowering female. This one in front is Thorillii by Aristolochioides. I highly recommend, if anybody is looking for a fast-growing, very easy to care for Nepenthes, it doesn't get better than this. Thorillii by Aristolochioides. Very, very fast-growing, very easy-growing. This is a male, and it did have a flower on it, but now it's no longer got that. But this is a unique one you don't see a lot of. This is Renoir Tiana by Rob Cantlii. And it is still relatively small. These pitchers will get well over a foot tall when it is fully grown. I am growing at this very, very stark angle because I'm hoping that it will basal for me. Let's see what else we got. This is one of my favorites in the collection. Gosh, camera work is horrible. I'm trying to find a picture here. This is the Glabrata by Aristolochioides, and this is probably the smallest Nepenthes pitchering plant that you will find out there. This is about as full grown. If I had a quarter, I'd put it next to it. It's probably half the size of a quarter, probably like a nickel in size. They might get up to a quarter at the largest size, but not much larger than that. Absolutely easy grower, fantastic plant, highly recommend it. Let's see here. This is my Alata by Caesar. So it's just like a lot of my truncata, except it's going to be much larger. And you can see its glands there. And it's producing some of that nectar there, which is really neat. Easy, easy growing plant. I absolutely love it. This is the Alata by truncata. And let me see if I can get a picture from it. They are very flimsy pictures. That one, there we go. Oh, this liquid came out. But as you can see, not much difference in the two. This one is more, it's actually longer, which is interesting, but this is the Alata by Truncata, but you can see it's a much more blanched out pitcher, but pretty cool there. Sorry, something just fell behind me. I don't know what that was. Let's see. Here is some of my Truncatas. This is the newest one on the, if I can get it to focus, there you go. This is the newest one on the JB by Patian. Absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous truncata. This is a smaller pitcher, which is interesting. I don't know, sometimes they just produce smaller pitchers, just kind of what they do. But as far as environment, nothing's really changed. It did get a little dry in here with the heat. It's been a little tough to keep everything watered appropriately, but yeah. It's a little smaller pitcher, but still equally as beautiful. Here is some of my babies that I've just got mixed in there, here and there. But as you can see, they are getting good size on them at this point. If you've watched, these have grown since they were itty bitty, itty bitty bitty. And they are now getting a pretty good size. That's probably the largest one I have. And then I have some here that are doing okay as well. They are definitely at the point, some of these larger ones, where I could up-pot them, but I have not done so. You can see that long leaf. This is a VTI hybrid, and that you can see that hybrid, that VTI coming out. But I've got them scattered all throughout the grow tent. Some of them over here, and I just kind of let them do their thing and grow along with it. I've got some over here. Not the best organization by far, but it seems to work. I'm getting to the point where I'm gonna need a bigger grow tent for sure. Back here, we've got that big Titan's Tower from Predatory Plants. It is doing very well, growing quite nice, as you can see, getting to the point where it's almost out of the ability to get it into the camera. So it's doing exceptionally well. We've got, I can't get back there just now, but we've got a new, this is Caesar growing. And then next to that is Brutus over here in this corner, doing very well. I'm hoping Brutus has got a basil on it, so I'm super excited about that. And hopefully that will grow out here soon. Let me see if I can get, this is the Titan Tower. Look at the picture on that thing, huh? Isn't that beautiful? Absolutely lovely, lovely, lovely truncata, doing very well. Let's see, what else we got? Here's another big picture. This is Diariana. Look at this. This is still a relatively small plant as well, but look at the size of those pictures. Absolutely gorgeous, tubby, beautiful coloring. I can't hold on to it. There you go. Absolutely stunning plant. Still, it's such a fast grower. That's what I'll say about this Diariana. Extremely, extremely fast growing. It's done very well. Renoir Tiana down here. I love this little plant. You don't see it for sale very often. Carnivorous seems to be the one that sells it the most, but it finally is getting its little eyes there. This is definitely, this is more of a weed of a Nepenthes in the wild, but I still love having it in the collection. It's just such a unique plant, iconic plant, and I absolutely love having it in the collection. And I just found this one. This is another Diariana pitcher. Looks so pretty. I love it. Look at the glands on the hood. Absolutely stunning. These things produce just enormous pitchers. I just knocked its juices out. Sorry about that, buddy. But it's doing very well. It loves its conditions in here. They don't like cold weather, so I live in Florida, so that works out well for me. Let me see if I can get in. I want to show you this spatulata by Merliana. Excuse me, Merliana by Sibionensis. See if I can get a picture on that. This thing is so hard to get to, but I would be remiss if I didn't show you. Look at these absolutely baseball pitchers. So beautiful. I love this plant. Did not grow well for me at all. I had it for a long time. Would not do well at all. And then one of you actually told me that it needed to grow closer to the ground. And since I've done that, it has taken off. Seems not like as bright a light. And definitely with that Sibionensis, likes growing on the ground. So done very, very well. It's continuing to grow. It's getting taller and taller. So I love that. Can't wait for those enormous, enormous pictures. All right, so that's certainly not all of the Nepenthes, but I'll make a part two of this tour. But I want to show you the sundews and just how much they have grown since the last video. Not only the collection has grown, but how big those individual plants have grown. So I'm going to take you over to the other grow tent and we're going to look at those. It is difficult to get back here. This tent is very small, but I wanted to show you these, how fast these bananas grow. I've got the different varieties here. In here, in the foreground here is filiformis. There's a Florida Red and then a filiformis by filiformis. But as you can see, there's a lot of staghorns in here. Let me see if I can pull up on one. There you go. See how beautiful that staghorn is. There is Multifida extrema right there in the middle. There is Bonata giant right there. And then these are just coming out. I just got these from a grower. I'm gonna highlight them once they get bigger. But this is that dichotoma giant that gets absolutely enormous. And so this plant alone will take up this entire grow tent at full size. Gets about 4 feet in diameter. I've got Evan's head back there. So there's a lot going on. Now, one thing to note, look, let's see if I can get it really close here. I'm gonna be making a video on how to treat this. I'm actively treating it now. I cannot get it to focus, which is super bummer. But I have got aphids. Aphids love capensis. And so I've got a ton of those. I'll show you in a minute. But unfortunately, that's part of the risk you take when you get plants, is that you're gonna get, no matter how good of a grower you are, how long you've been growing, you're gonna get aphids, and that's just the way it is. But I'm gonna make a video on how to treat that. I've been treating it and they're doing well. I've been treating it now for about a week or so, 2 weeks, and as you can see, everything looks great, not dying. What you will notice, this is a little sneak peek, is that the dew production will stop on them as they get a little stressed, but outside of that, they will do very well. I'll show you how to dilute it and do all that good stuff. So that's a big bummer, but it's part of the deal. So over here, I've got different Nepenthes, Reds, Alba, ICPS, Giant. Here, this pot is not doing well. I don't wanna say the grower that I got this from, but as you can see, this is Hercules, this is Wide Leaf, and this is the Montague Pass. All of these are absolutely enormous plants, but I think that the grower grows them in like 100% humidity. They have taken a long time to bounce back, but they are in flower and they are about to produce seeds. Next to that is my Lotus Eater by California Carnivorous. It is also producing seeds, so I'm very excited about that, and we'll have some nice plants, hopefully have some babies. I don't know if it is viable or not. The seeds definitely look viable, but we will find out. If not, I will do some cuttings. Then I want to show you something cool. I plan on making a video about this too, but this is all flower stalks from the Bonata. See, there's the Dichotoma Giant in there. Right in the middle is a Filiformis Californica that the leaf broke off when I got it in the mail, so I just threw it in here, and it has grown dozens and dozens of plants. But I'm gonna show you how to make, how to get flower stalk cuttings, and actually it produces a ton of babies very fast, and they're very robust. So I plan on showing you that. Here's that Dichotoma Giant's absolutely doing fantastic. But I wanna keep that closed because I do not want aphids getting in there. Aphids love the flower stalks and any sort of new soft growth. Over here, we've got the Utricularia collection. It's doing very well. You've got Lavidia Mexico here growing, but you see, I don't know if I can get it to focus. Aphids are on that. See those little tiny white dots on that one right here? Those are unfortunately aphids. So clear sign is when they'll attack the flower stalks. And when you get the flower stalks, you'll see them. They are a pain in the butt. They're not super detrimental to a plant. They will cause it a little bit of malformation as if they get too widespread. And they will stress the plant out a little bit, but they certainly aren't going to be as lethal as aphids or something like that. Even aphids aren't that lethal, but they're not going to be as bad as like mites or something like that, but they definitely need to be taken care of because they will spread. And once they get in there, I mean, that's the bad thing about gosh, my mind just totally went blank. Bad thing about aphids is that once they spread, they go fast, so it is very hard. It can turn into a wildfire very quickly, so you got to stay on top of them. But let me go ahead and turn the video around. I hope you enjoyed this video and enjoyed all the different ones. I will be doing a part two that I will link in this video once it's made, to go through some of the plants we didn't go through. There was a ton that we didn't get to touch on today, but for brevity's sake and for an appreciation of your time, I don't wanna make some hour long video, but there's a ton more to go over and I'm excited to share that with you. Some of them have not pictured for me in a long time and are now, so that'll be interesting to see. But I hope you've enjoyed this video, and as always, I hope you have a wonderful day and a wonderful week, and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.